At today's gun hearings, Representative Katie Porter got into it with a witness that had been brought in by the Heritage Foundation. And the witness did not like it when Katie Porter pointed out how that witness had previously misrepresented a proposed assault weapons ban. You'll see that in this clip.
Ms. Swearer, in 2019, you testified on Representative Cicilline's bill, the assault weapons ban, before Congress. At the 2019 hearing, Representative Jim Jordan asked you if law-abiding people will be less safe to protect themselves if that bill was passed. Do you remember your response?
I have a general idea of what I would have said under that circumstance, but no, I don't remember my specific words.
You said, and I quote, "I think worse than that, sir, you will see millions of otherwise law-abiding citizens become felons overnight."
Yes.
"For nothing more than having scary looking features on firearms."
It's true.
I was quite surprised by your answer. You read the bill before you came to Congress to testify against it, yes?
If we're referring to the ban on assault weapons?
Correct.
Correct, yes.
So you knew that the bill would allow any gun owner to maintain possession of any semi-automatic assault weapon that was lawfully possessed before the bill became law.
No, so that is the case under that bill. The problem is, anytime that is transferred to anybody else,
my time,
that
Madam
now
Chair,
becomes an issue.
Would you please instruct the witness that the time belongs to me?
Okay, so we're gonna have more of the video. There's a lot of that back and forth. The debate in the end though is very simple, so let's break it down. What she said, what was quoted directly there by Katie Porter, was that simply because the guns look scary or whatever, and in her extended testimony, which I watched, she kept going to like, this is just about people who don't understand what a pistol grip is or a barrel shroud or whatever, which is of course not at the core of concerns about assault weapons, that they will become felons because their guns have those things. And that is simply not true. In the bill, as she admits, you do not become a felon because you own a gun that was legal when you purchased it. The bill 100% makes allowances for that. You can keep the gun that you have. She understands that. The issue is that she wasn't brought there by the Heritage Foundation, either now or in past years, to accurately describe or analyze the Constitution or pieces of legislation. She's there to terrify gun owners and to try to derail gun reform. And so she got really snippy when Katie Porter pointed that out very succinctly.
Yeah, so there's a couple of different issues here that I really like and that it's important to you, for you to know about politics. So first of all, when Katie Porter reclaims the time, there's a reason for that. They have about a 5-minute limit where they get to ask the witnesses questions. And by the way, if the witness doesn't get to fully answer a question in the way that they want, they can have the next person, because they alternate back and forth, the Republican can then say, hey, you can finish your answer. Why did you think that the bill did X, Y, or Z? So it's not like she doesn't get any opportunity at all. The reason why people like Katie Porter, quote unquote, reclaim their time is because otherwise witnesses filibuster. You ask them one question and they take up the whole 5 minutes with a rambling answer.
Yep.
So that you don't get to your second, third, or fourth question. So that's why Katie Porter always reclaims her time so she can keep going forward. But I thought what was the most interesting out of all of this is, whenever Democrats go to testify in front of Congress, they are told by their consultants and clowns, do not ever challenge Republicans. No matter what insane thing they tell you, hey, isn't it true that the aliens kidnapped your body and now you're a lizard person? You have to be respectful and say, well, Senator, not exactly right, and be super polite and genteel. Do the Republicans look like they're doing the same thing? The whole time, even from the beginning, even before Katie Porter challenged her, she's like, yeah, I don't think so, Congresswoman, whatever, right? And what does that do? It creates an uneven playing field where the Republicans can say whatever the hell they want and the Democrats are always like, damn it. That's why we love Katie Porter, because she actually challenges, whether it's corporate executives or in this case, someone who's paid to make sure that there's no gun control so that there's more massacres of our children. She is tough in challenging them and we love that. But the minute it happens, Republicans are like, whoa, is this allowed? Mm-hmm. Is a Democrat allowed to fight back? What does she mean reclaim her time? So then they make a mess of it.
Exactly.
So really, is CENK the jank of the young jerks? The young Turks. CENK the jank. Is CENK the jank really sitting there and telling us that Democrats are telling, when their witnesses go to testify before Congress, just sit there nicely and behave. And don't talk back, don't clap back. Just genuflect and say, yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Yes'm. Yes'm. Yes'm, boss. Yes'm, boss. Is that what they're supposed to do? Act like slaves in chattel with the yoke chain around your neck and just sit there quivering before the big bad Republican senators or Republican congressmen or congresswomen and just quiver and shake and just answer the question with a yes or no. Is he out of his effing mind? Have you seen the Democrat witnesses that go before Congress and Senate at these hearings? They're literally jumping out of their chairs trying to attack the questioner. Just look on the internet. You'll see the videos that are out there. You see the clips. These people are loony, 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 loony tunes. All she did was is like sank the jank. He was like, I mean, what the hell is that? Is that what she was doing? I mean, we do all kinds of stuff. We embellish, we become hyperbolic. But that lady was just basically saying, you know what? There's a reason I said that. And then when you say something, you get slammed for it. When you don't say something, you get slammed for it. So what if she has an opinion on that thing that they're going to become felons? Because guess what? In the eyes of the law, they might, in the legality sense, they certainly wouldn't be felons. But do you think that people like CENK the Jank and John Isadora, his lackey over there, I don't know his last name, how to pronounce it. I apologize. You think these guys would care? They would absolutely say, you're still felons. You're still felons because you're possessing a handgun. And that's against the law, at least according to us. That's exactly what would happen. So in legal terms, perhaps they're not felons. But in societal terms, they certainly are. In the eyes of the media, they're felons. In the eyes of the Democrats, they're felons. In the eyes of Katie Porter, they're felons. In the eyes of CENK the Jank, they're felons. In the eyes of leftist, liberals, Democrats, progressives, they're felons. Just for possessing a gun, even though it's a perfectly right, they still say, well, that was a long time ago. It was for militias. We don't need militias anymore. Anyways, folks, we're going to get to more of the interview. But before we do, this is what we have on tap for you today. I'm your host, Dr. Nasir of the Dr. Nasir Shaikh Show, where I give you my political prescription from my political perspective of what happens when you have creatures like CENK the Jank, John Isadora, TYT, Katie Porter, the Heritage Foundation, the Second Amendment, Senate hearings, congressional hearings, they all come crashing together. Let's get back to the congressional hearing right now.
Look, there's a huge back and forth where Republicans try to jump in and say, let her answer the question. And Katie Porter's trying to move on to her other point. And the woman's trying to filibuster again. We're gonna skip that second video, actually. Let's get ready for the third one. Because at the end of the day, the debate is super simple. She is going to try to conflate two things. How she described what the bill does, implying that you would be a felon because you had already purchased a gun. That's clearly what she said. And then she tries to explain, no, what I meant was that if you later tried to sell it, you'd become a felon. Well, how is that overnight? How is that millions of people overnight? Well, the bill is very clear. You cannot transfer or otherwise purchase one of these guns. That's clear, everybody understands that. And so she's trying to conflate things to terrify people about the ownership rather than about the core, which is the transferring. She understands it, she knows what she's there to do. But also, she does have to deal with this new context where Republicans are feeling more heat about not caring about slaughtered kids. That is clear, they've gotten so defensive recently. And so I went and I looked up more of what this particular woman, Amy Swearer, had to say about this issue. And she, like some Republicans recently, wants to reassure you that they're not opposing gun control, not because they don't care. In fact, they care just as much as anyone else.
I just.
Everybody with a soul has it shattered. over acts like this. And we have seen it shattered every single time, from Columbine to Parkland to Uvalde. We did not somehow, this didn't get easier for us. We did not grow numb somewhere along the way to the reality of this. It's not as though our family members don't also teach fourth graders, or we don't also send our kids to school. It's not as though we don't also shop in grocery stores or go to country music festivals or work in hospitals, as though we don't also feel the tremendous, horrible weight of these tragedies somewhere deep inside of our souls, because we do. No, we oppose these policies precisely because the lives of these victims mattered.
A flat out lie. They oppose these policies because they're there to represent conservative electoral interests.
How do you know that's a flat out lie? I mean, I could say the same thing too, and I will. What you're saying about her is a flat out lie, Johnny boy. It's a flat out lie, Johnny boy. Flat out lying. You're lying about her. How's that? Say it to CENK UYGUR too. You lie all the time, big guy. Come on now. She had a passionate response, and she says she cares about these kids too. And you come out there and say that she's lying. How dare you? How dare you?
And the gun manufacturers, that's it. She can say we didn't grow numb, and maybe they didn't. Maybe they've been numb for a really long time. Maybe they started out numb, maybe they never cared. All I know is that she is there, and you can watch many minutes of her testimony. She's there to do what all the Republicans have done after this shooting and after all the past ones. She says gun control wouldn't matter. She went on
that
to
is
talk
so
about
true.
How,
gun control would not
earlier
matter.
Intervention, even though she doesn't mention red flag laws. She literally goes off about how we need more locked doors and everything, never explaining why the guy wouldn't just shoot out the windows on the first floor rooms with the assault weapon she has. She doesn't like being presented as someone who doesn't care about killed kids, but she cannot dispute the indisputable fact that she wants the next school shooter to be just as well armed as the last one. She can pretend to cry on tape about it, but that's what she's there to do. Her career is designed to make sure that the next shooter is as well armed as any soldier, any military around the world has.
Yeah, let me double down on what John is saying. That's Amy Swearer, and I think she's a liar. I don't think she believes a word she just said. All that fake maudlin emotion. Oh, you think we don't have kids too? Well, then what are you doing about it? What are you doing about it? We know for a
there's nothing you can do about it, CENK UYGUR. You just want to take away the damn guns from everybody. That's all you want to do. All these laws, it makes you feel good. Once, you know, you go home, you polish your halo. In fact, it's so bright, okay, and blinding. It's hard for me to do this video because I can't see through the blinding light, the glistening light coming off of your halo that you just polished, and that purse that you have when you virtue signal from above to everybody else about gun control and how we need more laws. It's an easy attack for you. We're the ones that have to defend ourselves, both from attacks from you and from basically defend ourselves from the, you know, the criminal element that you have. You could care less whether there's a criminal element out there attacking law-abiding citizens and taking away our God-given rights to defend ourselves.
Fact that the more guns there are in a country, the more gun homicides there are, and the more mass shootings there are. America leads the world in mass shootings by an order of magnitude. Among developed nations, we have 73% of all of the mass shootings. All the other countries combined only have 27%. All of them combined only have a quarter. We have three quarters. Why? Because they have gun control. We don't have gun control.
Oh,
there's
right.
Nothing we can do about mass shootings. It really breaks my heart. Did we, ching, ching, we got the money, right? Did we get the money from the gun lobby? Oh, yeah, that pays my checks? Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, I care so much. I think you're a goddamn liar, Amy Swearer. Go ahead, raise your eyebrow again. I don't care. It's people like you that are getting our kids killed and massacred. So don't give me your total BS, fake emotions there about how you care about the kids. We know for a fact it's the guns. It's definitely the guns.
Oh yeah, I remember when that gun walked into a store all by itself, no human being behind. It just walked into a store and started shooting off some rounds. Every single time that happens, right, CENK UYGUR? There's no human behind it. There's no person behind it. It's just a gun by itself, thinking, What's it gonna do? Hey, I think I'll walk into this school and do something, right? Is that what you're trying to say? You're the GD liar, CENK. We all know you are. You're the GD liar. You're the person with the polished halo talking down to us people. But I'll tell you what, if there was a situation in which you needed a gun out there, CENK the Jenk, you'd certainly want to be strapping, or you'd have protection of people around you that were strapping, you hypocrite.
And you go, oh yeah, who cares? Give it to him anyway. Second Amendment rights, wink, wink. It's really about the money, isn't it? Isn't it about the gun manufacturers that makes millions and millions and millions of dollars from those weapons? Okay, so? Second Amendment my ass. Was the shooter in Uvalde a part of a well-regulated militia? Was he? Was he, Amy? Was he a part of a well-regulated militia? Because then he would have Second Amendment rights. Show me which well-regulated militia he was a part of. Oh, that's inconvenient for you. Because then, we couldn't sell more weapons and then have a think tank like Heritage Foundation, who gets funded by giant corporations to help them make more money, come out there and think. They're just big thinkers in the think tank. And they thought and thought, and they saw all the numbers about how the guns lead to more dead kids. And they thought, yeah, we don't mind.
Yeah, it's all BS. They don't care anymore now than they did before. When they're dispatching, like literally the guy who was injured in a mass shooting, Steve Scalise, to say the exact same argument that Marjorie Greene made a few days ago, or maybe it was Lauren Boebert, I sometimes can't tell them apart, that we didn't regulate guns after 9/11. That's accurate. Yep, there was nothing that changed after 9/11. We
Thank
didn't do
God.
Anything in terms
Thank
of security.
God.
And in fact, right now, Thank I can God go they to did Walmart it. And buy a 747 and just take off from the street outside of my house, right? And there's no regulations and there's no training required. Or Louis Gohmert going up and saying that this is all due to the fact that there's not prayer in school. Just like disgustingly ignoring the fact that all of those kids were praying right before they were killed. We're supposed to believe that they care. We're supposed to believe that she cares about the law. The idea, even the Supreme Court interpreting the Second Amendment, that there's some sort of personal right to ownership of firearms, that was invented like a decade and a half ago, hundreds of years into the history of this nation. That is not at all how the Supreme Court had ever interpreted.
You have no freaking idea, John Isadora. God, you're such a stupid, idiotic, moronic retard. I've already given that acronym, okay, to the co-host, CENK the Jenk, Simmer. I coined it, stupid, idiotic, moronic retard. I now dub thee, John Isadora, if that's your name. I dub thee Simmer. S-I-M-R, stupid, idiotic, moronic, retarded, telling us that a decade to a decade and a half ago that the Supreme Court decided that the Second Amendment pertains to individuals. That's what I got from his rant right over here, folks. This is the retardedness of their issue, that it was never meant to be to have arms. No, never meant to be. Not at all. Of course not.
Interpreted the Second Amendment before that, but she's a legal scholar. She supposedly would understand that, would understand why in the slightly more than a dozen words in the Second Amendment, where exactly does it designate why you should be able to buy an AR-15, but not a fully automatic AK-47? Which particular word in the Second Amendment lets you have the AR-15, but not a bazooka? An AR-15, but not a tank. Where in the Second Amendment is that? Because you want to imply that the status quo isn't just a negotiation that we have had as a society. It's something objective, something philosophical, something legal baked into those few words. It's not there. We get to decide as a responsible society, or at least aspirationally a responsible society, since we clearly are not one, where exactly we draw the line. You're gonna try to draw the line where it financially benefits gun manufacturers. We're gonna choose to draw the line where it protects kids, or at least we're gonna fight to try to.
No, you're not. That's not where you're drawing this philosophical line, you. Have to calm myself down here. Could care less if I buy a gun and it supports the gun lobby, the gun manufacturer, that's perfectly fine. We buy it for our protection so we can protect our kids, you fool. That's what. So don't give me that crap that you're doing it to protect the kids. No, what are you going to say to the family that didn't purchase a gun and then got robbed at gunpoint, or something worse happens when they could have protected themselves? God, you guys are unbelievably polish your halos and speak with forked tongues. The verbal diarrhea that emits from your mouth on this issue is unbelievable. You virtue signaling hypocrites.
Draw the line there.
Yeah, so people in mainstream media tell me all the time, you have to respect Republicans. No, I don't. Where is that written down? Show me the amendment where it says I have to respect Republicans. No, I think they're monsters. I don't think they care at all about all those dead kids.
Neither do you.
And you know, you got free speech rights, so you go and give your BS speech in house about, oh my God, I care so much. Check, check, check. I got the check. Yes. Right?
Yeah.
And I get to give my
I got the gun.
Say, you
yes.
know what,
people, yeah, 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 I got
you're just
it.
Not heard like the Louie Gohmerts, the Mitch McConnells, who's the number one problem in America when it comes to gun control. All those Republicans, every single one of them drenched in money from the gun lobby and drenched in blood. Ooh. You should shame them.
Shame
you should
them.
Shame them. Never do anything physical. That's what the monsters on the right wing do, okay? But
oh,
you see
right.
them, so, oh, hey, you make money from.
Back that up there. The people on the right are the ones that do it. Every single historical riot that has ever occurred here in the last few years, in the last decade or so, was all done by progressives, by leftists, by liberals, by people that are trying to upset the society. You stupid-ass fool, CENK the Jenk. Look at the riots that happened after the 2016 inauguration of President Trump. Not a single person was charged. Now you're going to go back to, oh, what about January 6th? What about January 6th? It wasn't an insurrection, you fool. It was a protest and a demonstration. And if I wanted to go ahead and say, okay, we protested, we demonstrated, where were the burning buildings? Where were the banks being looted? Where were the destruction of private property, of people's stores, inconvenience stores, coffee shops? Where was that happening on January 6th? Oh, so they broke a couple of chairs in the halls of Congress and they went into the rooms. Oh, wow, death and destruction, despair. Our republic, our constitutional republic is going to be, it was shattered that day, shattered, broken. I mean, we're never going to recover from that. Unbelievably, unbelievable, these guys.
From guns? You're disgusting.
No, you're disgusting.
Oh, no, 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 you have to be polite. Why do I have to be polite to the elites?
Yeah, I have
are
to be polite to you, elite.
Are they
you're
polite
an elite.
To the kids in Uvalde? No, 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 no. Never anything physical. But we do not have to be polite to people who make money off the deaths of our kids.
Oh.
Thank God there's no landmine industry. Because if there was, they would go purchase the Heritage Foundation and Republican politicians. They would say, oh, no, no, we have a great idea for the mass shootings at the schools. We just plant landmines in the schoolyard. And they you
that's
think they won't do
what
it?
They've said you man think traps.
They, yeah. Yeah. No, they'll do it. They'll do anything for money. That's who Republicans are. They're monsters.
Yeah. Oh.
No amount of dead kids will get them to feel shame and feel like, oh, maybe I shouldn't take all the bribes I got from the gun lobby. Maybe I should actually care about other people's kids. It won't happen. Scalise himself was shot and he came back out begging for money from the.
Well, CENK the Jenk there on his typical rant against the Second Amendment, against the rights of the American people, linking the deaths of young children in these tragic situations where there's mass shootings that occur, linking them to the fact that it was a gun, that it was the, you know, the guns were doing it. Never mentioning that there's somebody behind that gun, firing it, pressing the trigger, doing, you know, the, you know, committing the violent act. It's just the gun. And all we, if we had a law that prevented that gun from being bought, it would have stopped the shooting right then and there. Listen, folks. We live in a community of 350, 360 million people. We are allowed to have guns for our protection. It is inevitable that these things are going to occur. And they are absolutely, I mean, when these things occur, everybody is saddened. Of course we all are, regardless of the political, but everything becomes political. Everything becomes political. And that's what these guys want to make. And then we've got to defend it from becoming even more political. Because if we give in, every single time, they're going to erode and take away one more right from us. Because inch by inch, inch by inch, inch by inch, that's what they try to do. Take away the rights of law-abiding citizens. That's what people like CENK the CENK do. That's what people like TYT and the progressives, the liberals, the leftists want to do. They want to take away any right that was given to us under the Constitution and for the freedom of our democracy. Anyways, folks, we appreciate you taking the time to watch. You've been watching the Dr. Nasir Shaikh Show. I've been your host. My name is Dr. Nasir. If you haven't done so already, we'd love for you to sign up, subscribe to the channel if you like our content. Like, share, and follow us. You all know what to do. Take a look at our video links here and below. My final thought is always, when you're right, you're right. And when you're left, when you're just a bloviating blowhard like CENK the CENK, always wrong. Until next time, folks, take care and stay safe.